Oh, hey, fellow scientists, Justin here. I've got big plans next weekend. Hiking, picnicking, maybe even flying a kite. I just hope the weather is gonna cooperate. You know, I know how to look at the clouds and the conditions to get an idea of what the weather's like today, but how am I supposed to know what it'll be like a week from now? I really don't want to get caught in the rain again. I think my socks are still wet from last time, but how can we know what the weather will be like ahead of time? By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to explain how scientists use data, technology, and their knowledge of weather patterns to predict the weather. Let's investigate. When scientists predict the weather, they're making a forecast. That's a prediction about the weather in the future. A forecast isn't just a wild guess, though. It's based on evidence. What kind of evidence do you think scientists use to help them forecast the weather? Scientists collect information about what's happening in the atmosphere right now, like the temperature, the wind, and precipitation. The scientists who do this kind of work are called meteorologists. A meteorologist's job is to study patterns in the weather so they can figure out what might happen next. To do that, they use special tools to help them measure what's going on in the air around us. Meteorologists need a lot of information to make a forecast. To collect it all, they use weather tools. Some tools measure what's happening near the ground, and others track what's happening high up in the atmosphere. What information do you think we could gather about the weather happening around us here on the ground? Well, when you step outside, what's the first thing you notice? For me, it's temperature. Does the air feel warm, or is it cold and crisp? We use a tool called a thermometer to measure the temperature of the air, which tells us how hot or cold it is in degrees. In the United States, we usually measure temperature in degrees Fahrenheit, but in most other countries, people use degrees Celsius. Both scales tell us how hot or cold it is, they just use different numbers. No matter which scale you use, though, a thermometer helps meteorologists know if the air is heating up, cooling down, or staying the same. And that can be a big clue about what kind of weather is on the way. Another important clue is precipitation. If you wanted to measure how much rain has fallen, how would you do it? You could catch it. Meteorologists use a tool called a rain gauge, which is a container that catches rainfall. The more rain in the gauge, the more precipitation has come down. Even a small amount of water can tell us a lot about what's happening in the atmosphere and what might happen next. We can also use weather tools to study the wind. What about the wind might you want to measure? One important clue is direction. Which way is the wind blowing? That can tell us where weather is coming from and where it might be going next. To measure wind direction, meteorologists use a weather vane or a wind sock. These tools point in the direction the wind is blowing. Meteorologists also want to know how fast the wind is blowing. For that, they use a tool called an anemometer, or a wind gauge. Its cup shape causes it to spin when the wind blows. The faster it spins, the stronger the wind. This anemometer has a weather vane on it, too, so we can see both the wind speed and direction. By measuring the wind's direction and speed, meteorologists can make better predictions about when weather will arrive and how long it might last. Thermometers, rain gauges, wind socks, and anemometers are just a few of the tools that measure the weather conditions close to Earth's surface. The weather doesn't just happen near the ground. Some of the most important clues are way up high in the upper atmosphere. So, to figure out what's going on up there, meteorologists use tools that can see much farther than our eyes can. One of these kinds of tools are weather satellites. Satellites orbit the Earth in the thermosphere and exosphere, the highest layers of the atmosphere. From way up there, they take pictures of cloud patterns, storm systems, and even hurricanes forming in the troposphere, where all our weather happens. This big picture view helps meteorologists see how weather is moving across the planet. Another powerful tool is radar. Radar sends out signals that bounce off raindrops or snowflakes. It shows where precipitation is happening and how it's moving. That's how meteorologists can tell when a storm is coming and how strong it might be. With tools like satellites and radar, meteorologists can gather information far beyond what can be seen out the window. But how do meteorologists take all this information and turn it into a forecast? How can we use what's happening now to predict the future? Forecasting the weather is all about finding patterns. Meteorologists combine all the information gathered from weather tools to understand what's happening in the atmosphere right now. Next, they ask, have we seen this kind of weather before? They compare today's conditions to patterns from the past. If the temperature, wind, and clouds match what usually happens before a thunderstorm, they can predict that another storm is probably on the way. But there's a lot of data, way too much for one person to keep track of, so meteorologists use powerful computers to help. These computers run weather models, which are programs that take what's happening now and compare it to weather information from the past. Based on how the weather has behaved before, the models show what's most likely to happen next. It's kind of like solving a giant weather puzzle. Each tool gives a piece of the picture, and the models help put those pieces together. The final picture? That's your weather forecast. Of course, even the best forecast isn't a guarantee, it's a prediction. Forecasts for today or tomorrow are usually pretty accurate because scientists have a lot of information about what's happening right now. But the further out you try to predict, the trickier it gets. That's because the atmosphere is always changing. Tiny changes in temperature or wind can grow into big differences in weather over time. That's why a forecast might say sunny skies, but you still end up getting caught in a surprise rain shower. It doesn't mean the scientists were wrong, it just means the atmosphere had a few surprises in store. While I check my weather app for my trip next week, let's review everything we've learned today. A forecast is a prediction about future weather. Meteorologists use weather tools to measure what's happening in the atmosphere. They look for patterns and use computer models to help predict what might happen next. Forecasts are more accurate for the near future than they are for days further out. To learn more about predicting the weather, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. Okay, it says sunny skies for next weekend, which means the picnic is on, the kite is packed, and I might even wear my good socks. But now I know that forecasts can change, so I'm also gonna pack an umbrella, a raincoat, and backup snacks. You know, just in case. Keep exploring, scientists. There's always more to discover beneath the surface. See you next time. Hey, hey.